equip, to encourage, to build, and to share the gospel around the world. As Jesus said in Matthew 28, He said, go into all the world and share the gospel by the power of my Holy Spirit, and I am with you always to the end of the age. Friends, beloved, it is the very heart of God to reach out to the millions of the dying people around the world, the hungry and the broken. And we are right here to equip them with the word of God.
After a new beginning of the El Shaddai ministry. And the Almighty God who called them, needed to guide. And from the like a seemingly mustard seed ministry that may grow into the plant and to the tree and the forest list.
Speak to me, the word of God. Speak to me. Speak to me, the word of God. Speak to me.
Today, if you want to see it, but exactly to somebody that was facing exactly the challenge, divorce, that was not getting across. I'm not for divorce, I'm not saying that. But she was facing a challenge, a believer got a raw deal. And she was coming out of it. I don't know how much this information will be exciting, much of an excitement, because I need to give you facts. Okay, because if you learn to live above your frustration, if you learn to live above your feelings, above your flesh, what she received, what was the word of your camels coming 2nd of December, what was spoken to her, her court case that was going on for about a year, what was told to her in March was that in this year the case is going to close, and she was not believing because it was not possible. The courts closed at on the 15th of December, so there was no way things were going to come. Camels were not supposed to be coming, but she heard that word and believed. God is impressed with what you believe, not what your feeling says, but what you believe. Because your feelings will always speak to you. But if you believe, you will see the glory of God.
Amen.
Exactly on the 8th, the lawyer called her. The hearing was in Bangalore. On the 12th, she's a Punjabi, so it's, you understand what 12 means. God has a good sense of humor. You are also surprised. So, exactly 12, out of the blue, not out of the blue, out of in the realm of the spirit, she got complete release. Suddenly, the man withdrew the case. Everything was settled, and the settlement was 50 lakhs. Of alimony, money even deposited, plus everything. I'm not here to pamper your flesh, okay? Because suddenly of it, the 50 lakhs come of it for excitement. But believe me, God is impressed. God delights in the prosperity of His servants.
Amen.
Alright, God is not against your prosperity, but hear this loud. If you learn to handle adversity, you are ready for prosperity.
Amen. Amen.
So whenever adversity happens to you, it's going to open doors for the next season of your prosperity. So don't get affected, because everything around you will start screaming, like John the Baptist said, "Behold the Lamb of God." And the next season, when he's in the prison, he's talking, "Is he the one? Or should we look for another?" When you make claims on church like John the Baptist, "He must increase, but I must decrease." But the season is going to be different when in prison you're not facing the very excitement of your season. But at that very moment, if you learn to live above your adversity, you are ready for your prosperity. Alright? Genesis 26 is going to be the season that we will enter in 2014. Okay, Isaac, to open the understanding, Isaac means you are the seed of Abraham in Christ. And the seed of Abraham, not of Ishmael, but of
Isaac,
the promised child. What is Isaac? What does Isaac mean?
Laughter.
Laughter. Learn to laugh at the face of your adversity.
Amen.
If you learn to laugh at your face of adversity, you are ready to overcome and seek prosperity.
Amen.
This is the way you're going to face the coming year. Because 2014 is going to open with a different challenge. But this is going to be in the very place God puts the challenge. If you learn to stand by faith, I stand in awe of you, that very same place is going to reap 100-fold.
Amen.
Because the famine that is already coming, is not for you, but for the people of the world.
Amen.
But the very famine is going to raise you up. So if you will see Genesis 26, Isaac comes, Genesis 26, 1. And there was a famine in the land besides the first famine that was in the days of Abraham. Now when was the days, the first famine in the days of Abraham? Genesis 12, 10. Okay, Abraham, so this is a pattern. What is a pattern? Wherever you see it happen consistently, that means it's going to be coming. It's a part of your journey. Abraham got it, Isaac is getting it. Isaac is getting it. Why were things written? Some people don't read the Old Testament. I pray that you will learn, because that's a shadow that you can actually learn to live. Where is the Spirit going to lead you?
Yes.
Okay, Romans 15 verse 4. Why are things written? Romans 15, 4. For whatever things, whatsoever things were written before time were written for our
learning.
You can learn from it. You don't have to stumble and learn it by experience. Some people say experience is the best teacher. But experience takes a long time, and I don't want you to learn it, okay? Because it takes a long time. You know who is the leader? He learns from the experience of others.
Amen.
You know who is the follower? He keeps learning from himself, trial and error. Do you have trial and error methods? God doesn't want you to go to trial and error. You have the word of the living God.
Amen.
It has gone, it has been tested by fire. So live by every word. So they are written for our learning, that we through
patience.
Last week you heard that word of patience. You need to hold on to the word of patience. That's going to open the new door for you. What was the last week's word for those who were not here? You're entering a season of an open door. At the same time, there will be a door of offense that will be opened. So the day you learn to overcome your offense, you are ready for the open door. Learn to grow above your offenses. Because the day you learn to overcome your offense, you are ready for an open door. And that is Revelation 3:8, where he says, I kept for you an open door which no man can shut.
Yes.
3:10 he says, why? Because you've kept the word of my patience. In 9 he says, there are people that's going to be opposing you. But don't get threatened, because verse 12 says, if you hold on to your crown, you will overcome it. Now does it look like you're having a crown? It's look like you're having a cross. But in your cross, learn to celebrate your crown. Because you have a crown that he has given to you, that Jesus said, when he was going through the cross, he knew what he was going to endure. Hebrews 12:3. He endured. You know what is endure? To see the end from the beginning. Endurance means see the end from the beginning. Who are people who can endure? If you learn to see that this is only going to be for a season. People who can't stay in the season are moved by the things around them, and that's the threat that the enemy, the trick of the enemy is to take you out of that very place of promise. So here you will have to see, be through patience and comfort of the scriptures. How many of you get comfort? Where is your comfort? Let me put it this way, believers get a lot of comfort from circumstances. Is it true? Of course it's true. Of course it's true. Everybody gets comfort from circumstances. Get me a bigger house. Nobody wants it? Of course you want it. But the day you learn to live the comfort from the scriptures and live by the word of God, you are ready to move beyond your circumstances.
Amen.
That's why. Now, that's the first introduction. What's the next one?
God will shake your circumstances so that you don't live by circumstances, by sight, but by
faith.
Because faith brings you the comfort to live by the word of God. And the day you learn to stand by the comfort that you receive from the scriptures, your circumstances are dead.
Amen.
Or let me put it, you are dead to your circumstances. You know who is after you get to die? Everybody says the enemy is after you to die. You know God is after you to die as well. Because until you are not dead, he can't live in you. That's why sometimes what you're binding is not Satan. What you're binding is God working in your life. So when you're facing a lot of uncomfortable situations, sometimes you say, the devil is attacking me. It's not the devil attacking you. God is working so that you will not live by sight but by faith.
Amen.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Some of you are looking to read Colossians 3:3. Okay, I'll give you scriptures so that you understand that this is not something against the world. For you are
dead.
Okay, you are
dead.
You are dead and your life is hid with Christ in God. Verse 4. When Christ is our life. So until and unless you are not dead, Christ cannot live. It's either you live or Christ lives. Some people, they allow Christ to live on a Sunday and then Christ goes back at home and on Monday they are alive. And then on Saturday coming back, I repent for what I have lived, I have to take communion. Christ come back in my life. And then back on a Sunday. This is where it's so important. Then shall you also appear with him in glory. If you don't allow his life to flow every day, you're not going to reign in glory. That's the key. Verse 5. How do you mortify? It comes from the word mort. Put to death. Mortify, therefore, your neighbors. Everybody thinks, you understand, it's my neighbor, I have to change. It's my boss, I have to change. Can you understand? The trouble is not around you. The trouble is in you. The day the flesh is dead, that is the day God can work. Mortify, therefore, your members. That means part of you that's alive, not to Christ, but to yourself. Part of you that's alive to the feelings and the circumstances which are upon the earth, fornication, uncleanness, inordinate affection, evil conspicuous, covetousness, which is idolatry, verse 6. For which things sake the wrath of God comes on the children of disobedience. He's protecting you from the wrath that will come if you keep walking in the same direction if you are alive to yourself. Are you able to get what I'm saying? Because I love you, I have to protect you. Because I love you, I have to make you dead. That's how I will have to bring the circumstances around you so that you are not open to the judgment of God, but you are open to the mercy of God.
Amen.
Are you getting what I'm saying? So it's not when things are getting harder, God doesn't love you. Things are getting harder shows that God is possessive about you. Oh, why do you love me so much? You're making things very hard for me. Is that right? When things are harder for you, that's when he wants you to spend more with him. Because he becomes, you just sang that song, Jesus, be the center. Everybody, be my souls, be my hope. Get what I'm saying? So it's good to sing. But the day when circumstances are not your center, God, if you don't give me this promotion, or if you give me this promotion, praise the Lord. When Jesus is your center, promotion is not from man. Psalm 75, 5 and 6. It doesn't come from the east or the west, it comes from the Lord.
Amen.
So whether they tell me I'm promoted or not, I'm already promoted because heaven is mine.
Amen.
Can I get more promoted than heaven? Oh no. You know, they wanted to make Jesus king. It was so funny. The King of Kings was, they were gathering to make, to promote Jesus to be king. You know Jesus did what? He ran away from them. If only some of us get wisdom, is that sometimes, you know, the very promotion that we are looking for is more of a demotion.
Yes.
Because it keeps us away from what God has for us.
Yes.
If they had made Jesus the king, he would today not be the King of Kings. Today, if some of the things God has kept it away from you, it is because He loves you so much that in the very famine, He is opening a door of favor. That's what you're going to be seeing. Genesis 26 is a door of famine that opens into a door of favor. What is 2014? A door that's going to open that looks like famine, but it you learn today not to allow the circumstances, the comfort that comes from it to speak to you or make you comfortable. You will rise above your circumstances and be able to make Jesus the center. Because when the king comes, the kingdom comes.
Amen.
And when the kingdom comes, is there lack in the kingdom?
No.
I love what Puneet wrote today morning. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. When He is Lord, there is no lack. When He is Lord, there is no sickness. So I don't need my boss to give me the promotion. I don't need favors from men. Although I'll be good to them. I will grant favors. Because my King has granted favors to me. Believe me, I'm not affected by whether anyone grants favors or not. Because the one who gives me favor is God Himself. And every hardness that He allows in my life is to be not a rock of offense. You know, Jesus is a rock of offense to those who don't believe or don't obey. But it is a precious stone, the cornerstone for the obedient. What is he saying? He's a stumbling block to a lot, but a stepping stone if you make him the center. Alright, so here you're going to be seeing verse 7. In the which you also walked sometime when you lived in them. What is he saying? That's the old man. So, who is supposed to be dead?
Old nature, old man.
Old man. I'm not talking about your dad. I'm talking about when people use that scripture, you know, Paul says, my old man is dead. It's not the old thing. You learn to put the old that you are so much moved by your flesh so that you learn to live. The old cannot live in the new season. That's why Jesus says you can't put the old into new wineskin. Because the old man, you know, he comes alive every day. Suddenly you are quiet. You know, Paul didn't say that statement, I die daily just for the sake of it. You got to tell that old man, go back.
What have you come here for?
And if you learn to do this, Christ can live in you.
Okay, verse 10.
And I put on the new man, which is
renewed
in knowledge. So where is the attack? The attack is on your mind. If your mind is renewed, you are a new man. If your mind is not renewed, you're screaming and you're crying and say, God, I've come after you and see all these unbelievers are better. They're not facing the same fire as what I'm facing. And you don't realize that God is allowing that same fire to refine you. You're going to be burned in that fire. But the fire is meant not to burn you, purify you. And once you are purified as gold, you are ready to receive the Job's inheritance. He gets double for all his trouble. So here you're going to see after the image of him that created him. When God has created, you know what is God impressed with? Because you are made in my likeness. I need to polish you.
Yes.
I need to purify you. And the more you are purged, the sooner you cooperate, the earlier he can operate. What is he operating? He wants to bring the kingdom on earth as it is in heaven. The owner of heaven and earth wants to come down in you.
Amen.
Pastor Syed said, you need to open a bank. I just smiled this morning. I said, with the way sometimes some believers are already operating, so I wonder where the bank will go. Because if the owner of heaven and earth comes down and he lifts that man up, if he opens that bank, it's got to be the bank that will bring glory to God.
Amen.
He doesn't want that the next day in the newspaper, Christian bank takes away all the money. What does that speak about the Christ that we serve? Did anyone say? Christ came to give life. So here is the key. What is God doing? God has to refine us before he resurrects us. And as he resurrects us, he's going to restore us. What is the process first? We don't want. Please don't refine us. Just resurrect us. But the refining is the very key. It begins in your mind. It starts with your mind. First, remember, you sang that song, God is? When? Can you sing it all the time? When things are going against you, can you still sing? In a famine, can you still say God is good? In your frustration, can you still say God is good? Because Isaac was ready for the season, for the best season of his life, but he did not see it. As a matter of fact, he saw it to be the worst. If you are a true believer, your very worst season is the place that God becomes the center to open the doors that you will see. The very wilderness is your wealthy place.
Yes.
Renew your mind. More than what I am saying, Psalm 66 verse 10, it's written in scripture, this is pattern. This is a standard pattern. So if you want to go to your next season, be ready. Okay, Psalm 66 verse 10. For thou, O God, has proved us. What is he going to do? Why is he purifying you? Why is he purging you? Because he wants to prove you. Whom is he trying to prove? Does he need to prove anybody? Whom is he
is he trying to prove? He's trying to prove to you. You don't know yourself. So you asking for promotion, but suddenly somebody comes and you can't handle that. Then you suddenly realize, I need to prepare myself. I need to prepare, because the promotion, let it happen in its own time. My job is to prepare, his job is to promote. If you just remember that simple equation, work on your preparation, God is working on your promotion. You know what people do? They work on their promotion. And the sooner they are promoted, the faster they get out. Because it's not the next door that opens. Here you will see, thou hast tried us as silver is tried. See where this man is going. Verse 11. Thou brought us into the net. Thou laidst affliction upon our loins. Adversity. Adversity is the test of character. Adversity is the very ground that will test your faith. Adversity is the very place that will test your foundation. How much deep is your foundation? Do you know a builder? Some builders have just laid, you know, something like that, and before long, the building has crumbled. The municipal go running after the builder. God is not that kind of a builder to allow that building to be all to be built. Just no foundation. So before he takes you to the next height, he has to bring the next depth. So if you were wise, what would you be doing? God, I'll operate in working towards the depth. Thank you, Lord. You're building depth. Somebody's upset with you? Instead of you allowing the flesh to respond, you allow the spirit to respond. Some things are bringing to remembrance of the old. You're closing that door and you're saying the old has no place in the new. So every step of the way, what is he trying to do? He's trying to work you towards to bring you higher. Here you will see, you can't have, what is that, verse 12? Thou hast caused men to ride over our heads. You had some people that had walked over you. So then be ready to walk in the heavens. Because if you have not reacted, you know the problem is what? If you are dead, when men walk over you and you are still dead, resurrection is coming. You know, some people get very touchy. You know, they're touching not. Some people have not been touched also, they're still touching. God is saying, I have a lot to work until they are not ready. If they have not gone through this, they cannot handle the wealthy place. Your wilderness is your training ground. Jesus went to 40 days of wilderness. And believers are saying, why do I have to go there? You want to follow Jesus? Wilderness is the very place that character is formed, that when circumstances will tempt you, what is Satan going to come? I'm going to give you this. What have you got to say? It is written. Your comfort is not in getting something. Your comfort is in standing where you are and saying, I will live by every word that comes from the mouth of God. That's where you are. Some you are going. So here, Genesis 26, see this. 2014 is coming. Genesis 26, remember this word. Because when you're out in the world, it's going to be a famine. When you're out
in your relationships, there will be famine. Because what is it, the sign of last days? The love of many will wax
cold.
People are going to be very different. I don't know whether you have noticed it, but I don't give too much of a notice to it, because I don't want it to go that deep inside. I just noticed the love of God. If you are so much Jesus is the center, you won't notice when somebody is unkind towards you. The love of God overcomes. Right? When things are just going against you, here you see, verse 1, Genesis 26, verse 1. And there was a famine in the land. We'll go fast now. Okay? Isaac gets an inheritance from Abraham. What is the inheritance? The promises of God. In blessing, I will bless you. People come to church on Sunday. There comes a prophetic word. The prophet comes and says, thus says the Lord. He goes back home and says, a season has just happened. And the first thing he sees the moment he reaches home, things are not better, but things are worse than it was before. Everything that's not supposed to happen is happening. Okay? In simple words, all hell breaks loose. Why is all hell breaking loose? Remember this verse of mine? Because you are ready for heaven. Not going to heaven, but bringing heaven down. That's why Satan gets threatened every time. So here in famine, just like Abraham, he gets a promise. The first thing he enters, he gets a famine. And what does Abraham do? Anybody remembers? Goes to Egypt. Egypt is a sign of the world. He goes to Egypt, tells a lie. Everybody is affected. And because of that, the king tells him, he gives him all the things and he leaves. But do you know, and I want you to hear this important, if you don't get things from the Lord, it will bring not the blessing that maketh rich, but it will bring a blessing that is enveloped with something that's going to pull you down. Who came in the midst? Hagar came in between. Who had sown that? You know, Satan is so, whether he's smart or he's cunning or strategic, what does he do? I'll give you what you have desired, but I will put that very thing that's going to put you down. Hagar was enveloped in the midst of every camel that was coming. So in one of the camels, Hagar was in. So when everybody was looking for my camels are coming, I said, oh God, I hope you don't have your eyes fixed on the camels. Because the camels are not your source. Christ is your source.
Amen.
If you are expecting for the camels to bring all the good things, that's where the danger lies. So here, what is God working here? God is working so that Isaac will die. Die to his flesh, to what he sees, what he hears. He's not going to have the comfort of circumstances. And you know, people who are shallow, how many of you want people who are deep, who wants to have long-term relationships? Do you think God wants anything less? God wants the same. God wants that today you are looking up, you are coming after me. Why are you coming after me? Heaven is yours. If you are coming after me and I don't give you anything, will you still come after me? Everybody says yes. Can I check it out?
Can I see you within the 6 circumstances? Can Christmas be an Easter where the cross is at work? Everybody is celebrating Christmas and I'm on the cross. Good Friday is coming. You get what I'm saying? Good Friday. After Good Friday is Easter. So always remember this. This is the key of everything that's coming in your life. You're looking for a person to enter your life. Check the person out. How do you check the person? Time is the key to test the person.
Amen.
Somebody gets married after a few months. Short-term relationship, long-term pain. They're ready. Ready to open doors for the next. So this is where it's so important. Time has to be tested. The day you learn to not live by your circumstances, this is the change God is allowing. Verse 2. And the Lord appeared. Can you see the Lord? Can you see the Lord? Why does God appear at a time when things are hard? Because God wants you more than the songs to make Him the stand that you will stand on. Are you able to get it? God appears to you. If you are only willing not to see anything to be the center, God will be the center. That's why He's very close to those that are brokenhearted. If you're hurting, He's very close to you, but then you have to be open to what He's going to say. The Lord appears. That's why faith is a foundation. What's the next foundation you need to have? Faith. If you have been walking on a foundation of what you see and what you hear, God is going to shake the foundation. God is going to make you stand on His word. Faith comes by? The Lord appeared to him and said, go not down into Egypt. Why? Like father, like son. Abraham went there. When Hagar came, he had so much trouble. Another Pharaoh will go and bring another one. Where will the whole world go? So what is God interested in? God is protecting. Okay, God brings you to church on a Sunday too. Speak to you. Your tomorrow, He knows it today. And that's why He tells you today what you need to know before you go into your tomorrow. Some people are not there in church, so they go into their tomorrow
and then come to church.
And then they come to church. Good one, you. Like that. And then they come to church. And the season is over. If you are already aware, God will speak to you in your famine, but are you there listening? And He appeared to him. Go dwell in the land which I shall tell you of. Stay put. Stay put. Be rooted. Don't be so fickle that every whim and fancies is going to move you like a... You have to stand on what God says. Sunday means I'm in the house of the Lord. I was so glad when He shared that word. That's why if you come early, you'll get it. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. How many of you look forward on a Sunday to go into the house of the Lord? Because God is going to appear. He's going to appear to you. You know the key of the secret of my prosperity? In every adversity, in every adversity, A boy who finds the Lord at the age of 18 moves, gets moved in everything. I knew it. The day I would come to the house of God, God would speak to me. I don't care, worry about who is going to be speaking. I just know, and believe me, God is a witness. I've always, 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 and I'm speaking thrice, that means it's from the Spirit, always been prepared for the next season, because whatever was coming, the pit that was coming, I was going to be the Joseph in that pit. That very pit was going to become the place of my promotion, because I knew it ahead of time what to do in that pit. Was God going to keep me away from that pit? No. He was going to allow me to keep going that pit, but He told me beforehand, when that pit comes, you just be prepared, because I can take you out of that pit for the next season. But believe me, that's going to come. Had I not been there, you know what would have happened? I would have missed my next season, because that pit would have made me to forget, or even not to know. The first trap that Satan wants to do is, you don't know what God is saying to you. If you don't know what God is saying to you, you don't know God. So, dwell in the land. What is it? Verse 3. Sojourn in this land. Which land? In the land of famine. Hear this word. Some relationships that you are going through has become hard. Stay in that relationship. Sojourn in that land. Some pressures that are going to come in the coming days are going to make you want to quit. What is God saying to you? You know, in Facebook, it's very good. I've seen this, quitters never win and winners never quit. Everybody. Only the problem is the person who's put that is quitting. You know whom is he putting it for? For the whole world to see. When God gives me a message, firstly, this was interesting. When God used to give me a message, I used to tell. Till one day he corrected me. He said, don't you think I've given the message first to you? I said, yes. So don't you think that it's for you more? I said, oh, okay. Then he said, don't you think that you don't have to share everything? Okay. So now I understand. What I have to share, you have to tell me what I have to share. That was the day when he started sharing me greater secrets. Because he could now trust me. What he's speaking to me, I will be obeying it. It is not for everybody else, it is for me. So, has the Lord appeared to you? Thank you. Yes. What is he saying? Stay put. 2014 is going to be a difficult year, but in the difficulty, you're going to see 100-fold coming back.
Amen.
In your difficulty, stay put. Stand not in the comfort of your circumstances. We got the song today, Jesus be the center. Make him the center. What is Jesus? He's the Word. If you have comfort of the Word, you will have his source. You will have his hope. And hope is the faith is the founder, substance of things. If you have no hope, and what is there if you hope for? Romans 8:24. If you hope for things that you can see, what is there to hope?
I've got good hope.
If you have something that you cannot see and you're still hoping, God is saying you are a man of faith. You're still hoping? When everything is shaking and you're still hoping? Then you are the seed of Abraham. And here, in this land, I will. Who will?
God will.
Yes, stay put and God will.
Amen.
You getting this? Don't worry about what you have to do. What you have to do is get your center in place. Circumference is coming in place. Matt is saying, it's okay now. And center is in place, circumference is in place. First thing you have to find the center.
Yes.
Then get everything is in place. Okay? So get your center. Your center is in place. Circumstances will come in place. Everything changes. Here you will see, I will be with you, I will bless you, and with your seed, I will give you, I will perform. Isn't it good? So, who becomes like Satan when he says, I will? There were 5 I wills of Satan. I will ascend there. I will
do this.
Whether you stop or you become dead. God, not my will, but thy will.
Yes.
Then you will see. Things are getting harder. Your will is at work. And what do? You go on your knees like Jesus and say, God, this may look like Gethsemane, but this will become a garden. Is that right? I don't see the garden. I see the Gethsemane. But I know, because you are the center, every circumference will come in place. And here, 5 I wills. Verse 4. I will make thy seed to multiply the stars of heaven, and will give unto your seed all these countries, and in thy seed all the nations of the earth be blessed. This is exactly the promise of Abraham. When you are in your tough place, celebrate the truth. Not complain about your troubles. You know, Isaac would have complained. You told my father, you told the pastor, you sent the prophet. Everybody was telling that I was going to come and have a blessing. I'm not seeing one. If you celebrate the truth will set you free.
Amen.
So complaining is not going to help. When things are getting harder, celebrate what you have in the truth of God. You have enough of God's word. Here you will see. Verse 5. Now see what is the key here? Abraham obeyed. When did he obey? You know when he obeyed? You know when, what is, which is this verse he's speaking about? Not only that, Genesis 22 verse 12. When he sacrifices his Isaac. Genesis 22:12. This is the one scripture that you will have. Sometimes God doesn't know how good of a believer you are. Do you know? I'm a pastor. I'm a bishop. All these things. I'm Abraham. This is one verse that baffles. And he said, lay not your hand upon the lad, neither bring thou anything unto him. For now I know. Who is saying this? God is saying. Hey, you. When it was hard for you and you still obeyed, now I know. Jesus be the center. He knows. It's a song. But when you are in the midst of your storm, you are saying, Jesus, you are my center. He says, now I know. Now I know. That means God till then didn't know how much is your depth. see the difference. The same challenge, Genesis 22, what Abraham faced, Isaac faced in Genesis 26. What he faced in Genesis 26, John the Baptist faced in Matthew 11. Is that a coincidence? No. That means in every believer's life, there will be a season that you will say, "Behold the Lamb of God." And Matthew 11:11. John was offended. This is what Jesus was saying. You know what? He was praising John. He was not praising John in front of the very people that came. Are you the one? No. Do you know Jesus praises about you? Not in your presence. He's proud of you and he talks about Pastor Sayer. But believe me, he doesn't want Pastor Sayer to know how proud he is. Because the moment he gets to hear it, he's opening the door for pride to come. Are you getting what I'm saying? So make sure God wants to celebrate you through the very things that you are going through it in your darkness, but he is bringing that depth and say, "See my son." He doesn't sing only on a Sunday. See the darkness that he can endure on a Sunday. That's exactly John, the same famine, when he was moved, was Jesus offended? Jesus was not offended. But he said one thing. Blessed is he that is not offended in me. That means circumstances will offend you. Things will offend you. But make sure that offense doesn't take you away from what God has said.
Yes, amen. Hallelujah.
Isaac stayed put. Then what happened? Genesis 26, 12. Isaac, he was 6, he stayed in the land. It was 12, he sold in the land. Now everybody thinks finances. You know what is sowing? Sowing is righteousness. Hosea 10:12. Sow in righteousness, reap in mercy. If you are doing, putting finances according to all that God has said, that is righteousness. If you are doing, what is sowing to your neighbor? Give them money? If they have a need, yes. What is sowing to your neighbor? Love your neighbor. What is sowing to your wife?
Love. Oh, what I believe. Is that the way to say love?
No.
That is righteousness. Social love.
Okay.
You know, I'm just giving an example. What is a wife's to sow? Are you able to get? Will there be hardness in relationships?
Oh God.
Will there be hardness in relationships? Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Someone so spiritual, you know. Will there be hardness? Yes. But will it be a time for you of sowing?
Yes.
That's when you get a hundred phone. Get it? Did you get this? When there is hardness and you are sowing in the very ground, you will reap, Genesis 26:12, you will reap a hundredfold in the land of famine. In the land of famine, when it is difficult for him to love and he's still loving, that's a hundredfold return.
Amen.
When things, I'll put it simply, when all hell break loose and you can still bring heaven on your face, you're sowing righteousness.
Amen.
Sow to yourself in righteousness, reap in
mercy.
Once you open doors to God, mercy, every blessing comes over your life. Mercy triumphs over? No judgment is coming your way.
Amen.
So,
hallelujah.
Keep sowing.
Yes.
Because you are sowing in righteousness, God takes care of the judgment. Because you are sowing in righteousness, God takes care of the judgment.
Amen.
Because you as a congregation, you're coming faithfully to the house of God and being faithful, you're sowing in righteousness, He takes care of your judgment. Amen? That's why you need to remember this. Sow and you will reap a hundredfold. Break up your
shallow ground.
Not shallow ground. The shallow ground will remain shallow. But because God knows there is depth in you, He says, break that fellow ground. Your feelings are speaking too loud. Not your fellow's ground, your ground. You know, people like to, you know, like Paul says, I buffet my body. You know, some people have seen I buffet my body. Break up that ground when your feelings are speaking loudly towards you. Don't. That's the time to sow. No, I'm not going to allow these feelings. I'm going to walk by faith.
Amen.
What is righteousness? Faith and love. Righteousness is faith and love. I'm going to walk by faith to walk in God's love. Definition of responsibility. People who are responsible are responding to His ability.
Yes.
So you are responsible. Responsible in the times when things are going against you, you are standing and not walking in the flesh, but walking in the spirit. Here you will see Genesis 26:12. He sowed in the very land when everybody was laughing at him. Do you know people may laugh at you, but eventually when God promotes you, they will cry, but they will have to laugh. Because you will have the last laugh. Come on, you didn't get this. I don't know how important it is to be an Isaac. Because Isaac means laughter. And he had the last laugh. Genesis 26 is that he had the last laugh over his circumstances.
Yes.
He had the last laugh over the Philistines. He had the last laugh over everyone that came against him. When you stand with God, you will always have the last laugh.
Amen.
With God, you are a majority, not because everybody may come against you, but when God stands with you, Psalm 2 is at work. You know Psalm 2? What is Psalm 2? When all the kings, they were working against the anointed, what was God doing in heaven? He knows how to laugh. Learn to laugh. In the very hardness, learn to laugh, because God is going to use that very laugh from the Isaac and show the enemy that, see, my son, you wanted to pull him down, but because he's seated with me in the heavenly places, he knows how to laugh.
Amen.
You want to put him under your feet? You are now under his feet.
Yes.
That's where And Isaac sowed in that land and received in the same year, 2014, in the same year, 100-fold. All these wraps, make it into slaps in the face. Okay, when the enemy comes against you, don't slap anybody. When you are sowing in righteousness, you are slapping the enemy. You are showing the enemy that you belong to the one who pick up the cross. And he said, if you don't pick up the cross, you are not my disciple. You are his disciple. You pick up the cross, you continue in his word. And the same, what Jesus did, he mocked the enemy. He made a public display. I declare to you this. Every one of you, God is looking to make a public display of the enemy through your life. I like it when there's a violence. When I see sometimes a violence that there is in Pastor Sayed. Well, of course, the violence that he shows to the enemy. Not to anyone else. But when he gets violent, I've seen the fire. And I'm not speaking about. Learn to get into, because the kingdom of God suffers violence, and the violent thing is
force.
Be violent when your own flesh is at work. Go against that flesh. Be violent against the thoughts that are talking to you and telling you to do something that's against God's word. Be violent at that time. Pull it down. Because he wants to make a public display of your life. You wanted to bring him down. You took his father away. You took everything away. Still, I can open doors for him. And he will be a witness and a testimony. The Muslim community will all say this and say, Jesus is Lord.
Amen.
Whether they want to acknowledge it or not, God has promoted it.
Amen.
But so in righteousness when there is famine. Because when God can trust you in your adversity, he can trust you with his prosperity.
Amen.
So in your adversity, keep sowing. Verse 13, see this. And the man waxed great. Who is that man? Isaac. Who is that man? You. And went forward. Don't go backward. 2014 is not for the backsliders. 2014 is the one who will stand and say, I'm doing this on a Sunday, I'm going to do this. That's what he said, 24/7. I love, we had services on Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Now we are starting it on Wednesday also. Now I'm looking for someone who will take it on Monday and Tuesday.
Hallelujah.
And only the pastor is there. Is that what I'm saying? If only the pastor is there, the pastor is going to read the 100-fold. I'm talking to you all. You want a 100-fold? Be consistent. Be early in the house of God. When you're coming to the, you've got an appointment with the president, and the president is waiting for you. Could you imagine this? You know, the president will just say, yeah, these guys have no respect of me. I'm waiting for them. What am I saying to you? I'm just trying to tell you. If you learn to give in your famine, you're sowing. What you are doing, God watches better, nobody watches. And see the difference. Verse 14. He became very great. God is going to make you very great in 2014. For he had possessions of flocks. I'm going to have possessions of flocks.
Amen.
One flock will not be only there. God has promised me with flocks. And possession of herds and great store of servants and the Philistines and with him. You are not, God is not going to stop working till the people are jealous of you.
Amen.
Some of you are not.
Amen. Amen.
I'm the only one excited.
Hallelujah.
I'm not here to tell And you are not working for to make people jealous. You are working because you want to bring glory to God.
Amen.
And people, whether they like it or not, they are already jealous about you. Have you got that revelation?
Yes.
Don't worry, I'm all right. One way or the other, anything that happens, good. But believe me, it's coming your way. 2014 is going to be a prophetic year for you.
Amen.
All right, they're going to envy. And see this. What are they going to do? What's next verse. For all the wells which his father's servant had digged in the days of Abraham, his father, the Philistines had chopped and filled them with earth. Do you know this is today the state of the church? People that used to open their wells to give him praise, today are quiet when the praise and worship is going on. My father was like this. I was like this when I was a young believer. When I was a new believer, I praised the Lord. The wells were open. What happened to those wells? Some of us were more of a believer when we got saved than later. The latter glory is greater than the former. That's God's word. What is man's word? Former glory is greater than the former. They're becoming dimmer and dimmer. You don't even know. Somebody who told me, he said, we had a dead, we had a person who died in the church, right in the big church. They had to literally, it took them half an hour to find out who was there. When the ambulance came. Not only such a useless, such a bond dead congregation. It's time, dig the wells. The well, what is the enemy strategy? You're coming to church? What has God done in your life? They will try to put the wells. When you used to say, Jesus is Lord, they will try to quench that. When I was a new believer, I had a small car. Just a small. I put in big letters. I had an unbeliever dad who was more upset than anything else. But I was so much in love with Jesus. Jesus is Lord in a Muslim country in Indonesia. I just told my dad, right, put it. Until one believer said, what are you doing? Don't get so excited. Make it easy. We know Jesus is Lord, but we don't know His Muslims. Before long, that Jesus is Lord is gone. And then when I look back, I said, you know, why did I go? I should have not only put it on the back, I should have put it everywhere. Because was that not what Jesus said, that you will be persecuted for my sake?
Yes.
Blessed are you when men persecute you. Why were the believers telling me to stop it? I never knew this. What am I saying? In the eyes of the Lord, you are blessed when you stand for your faith. In the eyes of, you know, make it a little bit milder. Don't show that you are such a believer. No, because if you show to people, you know what I said, everybody will come against you. Just be a nominal. Put one leg here, one leg there. You know, nobody will know the difference. Have you tried walking down the steps, you know, standing one leg behind and one leg behind? What kind of a position looks? Either stand on one step or the next step. So please be clear about where you are. That's why Jesus was like, either you be hot or cold. Don't be in between. So here he was very clear. The wells, they went against. Alright, this man is going from glory to glory, from faith to faith, from strength to strength. Let me stop him. That means 2014 is going to be a challenging year. But in the midst of challenge, if you will stand with the cross, He's going to make you more than a conqueror.
Amen.
So don't be intimidated by the challenges. What was the challenge here? They tried to close the wells. 16. Abimelech said to Isaac, who is he? He's a king. Go from us, for thou art much mightier than me. Is God going to make you lesser than others? No. But he's going to use you to be greater than others, so that he will get the glory, not you. So until you are not dead, he cannot live. So here, next verse, we're going to close here. Well, and Isaac departed from there and pitched his tent in the valley of Gerar in Gerar. What was it? From famine, he moved to flourish. From flourish, he went to the valley. Did he leave? No. God told me to stay, means I stay. I will be polite to you. I will be good to you. I will give you the smiles. Okay, you want me to move? I'll move. Okay, but I'm going to be here. I'm not going to be moved. I'll stand. Even if I have to stay in the valley, David conquered his Goliath in the valley. My Goliath is going to be conquered in the valley. You don't like me as a believer? I'll sit on one corner. They tell me to stop reading the Bible, never mind, God will still speak to me, because it's not only the word, he is the spirit.
Amen.
He can still speak to me.
Amen.
And all that you need to do is don't deny your faith, because it's a foundation.
Amen.
Amen.
Because when your foundation is intact, God is going to lift you up. If you go back home, read these passages if you want to go to 2014, don't try. Okay, for the sake of time. One challenge after the other. There were three places he digged wells. Isaac, what was he doing in the valley? Makki Mari. These are most of the believers' strategy. Just pass time. A pastime, what you got valuable time, you got God's word. You got the treasure in front of you. Kings, when the book of Proverbs says that it is better than gold, if gold would have been kept in front of you, what would you have done? Some of them are bringing from Dubai. Today the book, the price of gold is, they're making clips for that gold. Here you don't have to make clips, you just have the word of God in front of you. If you are in the valley, keep digging the wells. What are the wells? The revelations that God has given to you earlier. The camels are coming. Some things the Lord has spoken to you before. Go into the word, start digging it. Oh, yes, I remember it now. Ah, you told me this. When I was a new believer and I was fighting this battle, when you spoke to me this, I did this. Ah. One well he did, the Philistines came and took it away. He did another well. Sitna. He said Sitna means one is contention, one is strife. There will be contention, there will be strife around you. 2014 may not be an easy year. But in the very year that you will see the strife, God is going to lift you up.
Yes. Amen.
Because you are not a person of strife, you are a person of peace. You know what Isaac did? Tell Mele. You want this, no? take. Because the day you remember, like Abraham, you know, Lord, and Abraham who fought, Genesis 13, reading verse 7 and 8. The moment God said, let's, Abraham, who knew his God, people who know their God don't fight for their rights. You know what is your right? Your responsibility is responding to his ability. No, Abraham said, take the one, whichever side you take, I'll take the balance. And with that balance, God blessed him. Because after he gave to Lot, God spoke to him, he appeared, and he told him, now you look to the north, south, east, west. As far as you can see, I've already given you. What more do you want? So again, I'm saying to you, in the valley, don't waste time. You've got little time. I've only seen once in a bus, one lady reading a Bible. Manisha, the first time. I used to travel in buses. There were days when I used to do that. One day, I got into the wrong bus. And I said, God, why did you spend me? And always remember, sometimes the steps of the righteous are ordered by the Lord. So you won't understand why you are doing it, but still you are doing it. And I got into that bus and I was just waiting and I saw this girl opening the Bible. And I said, fantastic. I have not seen such a... She doesn't want to waste a moment also. She's reading the Bible. I come a little closer and I found Malaysia. I don't know whether she noticed me, I don't remember that. But I got down in the next stop. I said, if there is more, something I will do now is to find a suitable one. And before long, we found Pastor Sayer. Now three mighty ones are being raised by them.
Amen.
Amen?
Amen.
Dig the wells. He was caught unaware. Dig the wells. This is given to you, blessed. So again, the enemy will oppose you. In the very Isaac, Sidna, then comes Rehoboth. What is Rehoboth? God has made room for us. 2014 is not only going to be a year of 100 portion, 104, God is going to make room for you. What is it called? It's going to be a wealthy place. It's going to be a large room. If you read the story, the conclusion is, Abimelech comes running to him and says, you have become greater than us. You're not leaving us. Make a covenant with us. Your unbeliever family is coming to the Lord in 2014.
Amen.
When they see how blessed your God is opening doors for you, they can't help it, but they're going to come and say, now I want the God that you serve. You read that closing. He comes and makes a covenant. The covenant that you carry is going to activate every blessing as we partake in this communion. Be mindful of this covenant always. 1 Chronicles 16:15. Be mindful. What is your mindful of? Be mindful of this covenant always. He did that, she did this. My boss is this, my wife is this, my husband is this. No time for this. You got a covenant? 16:15.
First Chronicles 16:15. Be a mindful always of his the word which he commanded to a thousand. Are you worried about your generation? God is going to take care of your thousand generations. Deuteronomy 7:9, he's going to bless you to store a thousand generations. Psalm 89:34. My covenant will I not break nor alter. The thing that is gone out of my lips. What is the thing that is gone out of his lips? I'm going to make you the head and not the tail. Alright? Keep sowing. Now what is the challenge? You're going to partake in this covenant. Okay? If you are saying it from your heart, repeat this prayer. Okay? We are going to cancel, uproot every wrong sowing. Every wrong sowing that we have done in the flesh, uproot it now and get a fresh start. Okay? Start saying, Lord, the harder it gets, the bigger the pit. Read after me, Heavenly Father. I celebrate the truth in the midst of every hardness. Today, I receive your word in this heart. You have sown it in good ground. It will reap a hundredfold. Because today, I repent of any sowing that I have done with my mouth, with my mind, in my heart, that is not in line with your word. I repent of it. Through the blood of Jesus, I receive today the mind of Christ. I receive a mind that is full of your covenant. I thank you, Lord. I celebrate the covenant that you have given to me. That in the midst of the famine, I will sow in righteousness. I will reap your mercy. I thank you, Lord, that you took away